Hey guys, welcome to another Your Tech Report video. Today we're going hands-on with the Apple Watch Series 7. Welcome to our channel. Thank you for being here. If you're not already subscribed to our channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. The notification bell is pretty useful as well. It'll help you get notified instantaneously when we've got a brand new video just like this one to share with you. Apple Watch Series 7. This is the latest release in the Apple Watch lineup from, of course, Apple in Cupertino, California. This watch, if you've read a couple of reviews, you've seen the unveiling, doesn't have that much that really sets it apart from the previous generation model, the Apple Watch Series 6, except for three things in particular. The screen size, the overall size, even though it's hardly noticeable, and the durability. So let's talk about the similarities first, and we're gonna go to our overhead shot here. If you look down in my right hand, I've got the Apple Watch Series 6 with the gray Nike sports band here, and then I'll take the Watch Series 7 off, and you see I'll put that right side by side next to it over here in the middle of the screen so you can see these next to each other. And the first thing you'll notice is definitely the screen size, especially when you see the unlock screen right there in front of you. So you've got the keypad, which you can see right away. Number one is that the Apple Watch Series 7 on the left has a noticeably brighter screen and the buttons are a lot bigger. When the numbers do pop up on the screen, you'll see right here when I bring them back up, the numbers are definitely better spaced and larger on the screen, which means it's going to be easier for you to type in your passcode. Now, the other thing you'll notice, especially when it comes to the screen, and we'll get that lock screen away, is when you're looking at images like this watch face I have of my dog Augie, you can definitely see that the screen has been extended enough that it goes to the edges and almost wraps around the edges of the glass. Whereas in the previous generation model over here on the right, you can see that it's kind of cut out and you've got a pretty substantial bezel there. Now that is thanks to extending the screen. What they've done is because they reduced the borders by 40%, you're actually getting 20% larger of a screen in virtually the same size. Now we're talking about millimeters of difference here. Now with the screen off, you can barely notice the actual size difference in the two watches. It's really hard to tell when they're side by side like this. Now, because of this change, this 44 millimeter watch from last year is now a 45 millimeter watch. So that size difference, you'd wonder if it's going to be compatible with all the sports bands and all the bands Apple Watches have been coming out with over the past, six generations. And yes, they're absolutely compatible because when you look at the actual side of the watch where the watch bands actually come into play, the difference in size is so minimal that they managed to keep those dimensions exactly the same. Now, if you followed a lot of the rumors leading up to the release of this watch, we expected a whole brand new design. We expected a flatter, thinner, more kind of a contoured, kind of like the new iPhones are, but that did not happen. Instead, we got a watch that's very similar to last year's model. On the contrary, on the inside of this watch, everything's exactly the same. You've got the same processor, the same amount of memory. Everything physically inside the watch is the same. You've got a cellular or a GPS option, depending on which one you choose from. So other than the screen size and the real estate, you're not getting that much of a difference. So when people ask me, do I upgrade to this watch? My question really back to them is always going to be, well, what did you have before this? What are you upgrading from? If you're upgrading from a Series 6, even a Series 5, I'd say, you know what? Hold off. Don't spend your money and wait till next year's model and see if we do get a radical redesign on this watch entirely. So let's put the Apple Watch Series 6 to the side for a moment and let's focus on this Series 7 and talk about what really is different. Well, you'll notice the screen difference when you swipe up and you actually see buttons on the screen. That a big noticeable difference is the size of the buttons and therefore the way you can click and interact with them. Now, when I go to an app like Messages or Mail, for example, let's go to the Mail app here and let's bring up the keyboard so we can see what composing a message looks like. So you can see right here when you go into composing something, the keyboard is actually larger on the screen, which makes it a little bit easier to type, but because you also have swipe, it makes it even easier to type with that larger screen. So I could do things like say, hello, my name. Okay, well, maybe not too accurate, but you get the point. I still enjoy using verbal commands and using Hey Siri in order to get commands going on this watch. And as you can see, she's pretty smart there because it's listening right off the bat and I didn't have to say it loud. I didn't even have to raise it. It's actually sitting here on the desk and it's actually listening to everything that I'm saying over here, which is pretty cool. The always-on display is actually a lot brighter, so when you're not using the watch and you kind of take a glance at it, it's not as hard to make out what's on the screen. You actually notice that when you're looking at the watch and you're actually interacting with the watch, the brightness is exactly the same as the previous generation. situation. Now, they talked about ruggedness, and the reason that this watch is more rugged and more impermeable to cracks and stuff like that is that the glass is actually thicker, but you don't see it over here because it's actually thicker in the actual frame of the watch. So they thickened it up. It's now dustproof, continues to be water resistant up to 50 meters. So you can definitely swim with this. You could track your swimming. You could track all your activities. And if it falls on the ground or if you whack it against things when you're, you know, using it on a daily basis, you're less likely to crack that screen, even though I've never cracked the screen, and less likely to get scuffs on that screen as well. So it is a little bit more indestructible, so to speak. So it's IP6X dust resistant, which is something that's new to this year's model. And you maintain the WR, the water resistance of 50 meters, as I mentioned earlier. So no problem splashing it and no problem swimming with it. The health features are the same. You've got the blood oxygen meter. You've got the sleep tracking that's built in there. You've got a little bit more battery life and a quicker charging time. That's thanks to a new charger that's on board this device. Inside the box here, as I actually show it to you on this overhead cam, you'll notice that there's an Apple Watch charger, but it's a little bit different because it features USB-C, and this charger itself, and this is the one that comes with the Series 7, has an aluminum ring around it, and that differentiates it because this has a higher and faster charging speed. And with a proper brick, you can actually charge 33% faster than the previous generation Apple Watch Series 6 or anything before that. Now, don't expect to use this on an older watch and get that faster speed. It is only compatible with the new Watch Series 7, meaning it's only going to charge faster with the Watch Series 7. It will still charge older devices. Now, reciprocally, if you have an older Apple Watch charger, it's not going to charge any faster, no matter on the size of brick you have. You still need to use this specific charger with this specific watch to get the 33% faster charge time. And they're saying within just a couple minutes of charge, you get up to an hour of battery life. So if you find that you're waking up in the morning because you're sleeping with it and you want to throw it on the charger while you're getting ready, in about 8 minutes, or the amount of time it takes you to get ready in the morning, you'll get a good boost out of that watch, and you'll probably top up the battery enough to get you through the day. This is the midnight color. I'm going to hold it up to the camera here so you can kind of get an idea of what the color looks like. Compared to the Series 6, which is the Space Gate gray color, it's got a little bit of a blue hinge to it, but it looks like a dark matte black, which is actually quite nice. And this is a new graphite color band, which is quite nice as well. Not as dark as the black, but you get this kind of graphite, almost gray tinge to it. Now, colors available this year are green, blue, product red, starlight, and midnight. Some people are complaining, where are the other colors? Why don't I have space gray? Why don't I have rose gold? Well, those are the color options available this year, and that's what you can buy right now in the Apple Store of your choice. Now, supplies are limited. I ordered a launch day version, and it was delayed the day before it was supposed to arrive. It was supposed to be delivered on the Friday, but no, it said delayed till end of October. So if you want to get this in time for the holidays, I highly recommend you place your order now so you don't miss out on that holiday rushing season. So that is our first look at Apple Watch Series 7. Again, available now at the Apple Store. Again, all these colors are available to you if you head on into the store, along with a whole new variety of watch bands as well. Starting price is $399 US, $529 Canadian. That price, of course, for the GPS entry-level model with the aluminum case. You can choose stainless steel, plus you can choose LTE models and other color variations depending on what you want. You can go high-end with that Hermes strap, perhaps, if you are looking for that option as well. Guys, thank you for watching this first look at the Apple Watch Series 7. We're gonna keep this on our wrist for a couple months and let you know how we feel about this on a daily basis. Is the battery life a bit longer? How durable is that new durable display and the shell casing? And we're gonna put it to the test. So if you've got something that you want us specifically to pay attention to on this Apple Watch Series 7, let us know in the comments down below, and we will definitely get to that either on another video or on our SiriusXM show, Saturdays at 1 p.m. Eastern. Thank you for watching. If you're not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button down below and that notification bell, and we will see you on our next video.